This is Megan Alves with CoolCleveland.com, and we are here with Tom Megalis at his studio near downtown Cleveland. Let's look around his manic world and see the amazing things he creates here. So Tom, we are in your fantastic studio space. This place is wild. Why don't you tell me a little bit about the building and how long you've been here?
Look around. There's pipes. There's all kinds of cool things because it was an elevator factory. That's where they made elevators. Right here, Tyler Elevators. This is Tyler Village. That's why they call it that. I've been here for 79 years. No. It's been a short, seven, 8 years? I don't know, somewhere around there. But yeah, I've taken it over. At one point, it was empty. I thought, how am I going to fill this? I had like a pad of paper and a ukulele, which I never played. And I was sitting here going, how am I going to fill it? But as you can see, I've packed it. Packed it with stuff I find on the streets. Packed it with materials, paints, wood, because I use everything, Megan.
There's a huge variety of art. What media do you like to work in?
I work in wood, metal, fabric. I mix materials because I love materials and I love sort of patterns, and that's the Greek in me. The puppets found me. They're friends. That sounds a little psychotic, doesn't it? No, I made them, a lot of them, and I used to have a group of people. There were tons more puppets. Because I was doing stuff for Nickelodeon and Comedy Central. And this is what's left of my puppet kingdom. But essentially, they're actors.
Very well-behaved actors.
Oh my gosh, they are. No potty breaks. I don't have to give them coffee. They don't ask for raises. And they're very small, so you can fit a lot of them in luggage.
And a lot of your work does address social and political issues, too. What kind of issues really inspire you to go to canvas?
That's like the more serious side of what I do sometimes, where you, like anybody, you get affected by things that are happening around you. The one piece there, which was the Tamir Rice shooting, which was kind of a controversial piece, but I did it out of kind of my reaction to being, I was a father. My studio is here in town. It happened close by. It affected me deeply, so it was a response to that. And the other gun violence that happened in Squirrel Hill in Pittsburgh, I lived there. My studio was there. I went to school there. I lived in that neighborhood of Squirrel Hill. So these are things that like really affected me. And they bubble up. And, you want to put them out. You want to sort of, see where... and sometimes you don't even think about it. You just start drawing and kind of painting and making, constructing. And you're like, that's my response to this. And sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
Now, you have an upcoming show in Columbus, right, that some of that work is going to be featured in. Tell us about that.
Right. Well, the gallery, Not Cheap Gallery in Columbus, March. I think March it's going to happen. Two pieces are going to be in there. And one of them on unnecessary incarceration and another piece on gun violence. And it's a really cool gallery. It features artists that are, political, social, that are talking about issues. And, sort of artist is activist kind of thing. And it's exciting.
And then how do people see your work in Cleveland? What's a great way to see what you're up to?
Morse code. That's hot. The only way to reach me. No, that's when this building was put up as Morse code. No, TomMegalis.com. That's my thing. On Facebook. I love friends.
And they can come visit you anytime, right?
They can come visit the studio. East 36th Street between Superior and St. Clair near the lake. The wonderful Lake Cleveland. And if you're really nice, I have a boat we can go to Canada.
Well, on that note, thank you for having us here. Lovely space. And it's been great.
Yeah. Thanks, Maggie. You're the best.
So there you have it. Tom Megalis' amazing studio and great art. Stop on by sometime and take a look. This is Megan Alves from Cool Cleveland signing off.